Evoland 2, A Slight Case of Spacetime Continuum Disorder. Episode 14, 100 Years Later. Previously, on Evoland 2, A Slight Case of Spacetime Continuum Disorder, our heroes find that much of the continent has been obliterated. Let's see. Nope, can't go that way. I don't think I need to go to the harbor. Let's go to Geneva. Things have certainly changed around here. We'll start the gates open.
You are now entering the great trade capital, Geneva. Be sure not to make any trouble, and we'll ensure your safety. Traders are disciples. Traders are disciples. All day long, all I see are traders and disciples. It's crazy! Has someone really become a traitor or disciple?
How should I know if only you just got here? Yet it's changed quite a bit since.
You just got to Geneva, right? It's obvious from your tan, you spend too much time outdoors! Over, my delicate skin is protected from the sun's harmful rays by the vapors of the smoke!
Yeah, I know, you would be smug if you survived something that obliterated much of the continent. It's a great honor for a disciple to be able to spy, to guard Mr. Fogwell's home. Don't know Mr. Fogwell? He's only one of the richest merchants on the whole continent. Are you in the market for a smug fuel furnace? Step right up! Ours are the very best out there. Guaranteed to have minimal smug emissions. And at an unbeatable price too. Buy a smug furnace and you'll save on wood. It's very good for the forest, did you know that? And if you purchase one right now, you'll pay 0.1% less tax. So, what you say?
Yeah, why not?
Wonderful! You have no home. You'll have to buy one before having a smug furnace installed. Find another trader for that. I don't do scam, real estate.
Yeah, it falls as much.
When I was little, I'd always go ahead in the sewers with my friend. Full of rats and other disgusting stuff, but man, did we have a good time. But ever since the great disaster, I just don't enjoy life anymore.
Well, at least you have a life to enjoy.
Do you really think the great disaster caused the great disaster? And what about this business with the five keys we need to collect before destroying the world?
Got me.
Our family has been poor for generations. But at least before we could see the sun. Now everybody won't use this smoke. The smoke blocks out the sun and everyone gets sick. Traders are the only ones getting richer. What do we care over him? I worry about my daughter's future. Mommy worries a lot! Are all the items like that?
It's a bit worse. And
what? Oh, my sweet. One day I'll take you far away from the smug fields, all the way to Silver Forest where time stands still. Our love will be eternal there.
Frostbitten bodies.
I am your faithful knight. Your wish is my command.
Oh, my love.
Oh, my darling. How about I invite my mother to come along?
How about we forget the whole thing?
Just as well.
It seemed like a good idea, didn't it? Seemed like a good idea, didn't it?
No, it was all kinds of wrong.
A disciple is trained at the Prophet's Pyramid west of here. It's got a big eye engraved on it. You can't miss it.
Suspicions. This was different.
Back in the Imperial days, this place was an orphanage for children whose parents died in the war. Nowadays, it's a home for people bankrupted by the traitors, and who have nothing left. I would have preferred taking care of the children. Adults only get what they deserve. It's their own fault if they're in debt, right? Makes you wonder why they do it. Didn't anybody tell them that what might happen?
Why? Why? Why did I accept that contract? Every day I ask myself the same question. over and over. My wife's never forgiven me. To think that I was taught to just say no to traitors who want to sell for me things I don't need. Leave me alone. I just want to die alone. I really tried, you know. After working so hard. I almost managed to become a traitor. Now I've lost everything. It's my fault. All my fault. At least it's better than a debtor's prison. Shop, perhaps I can buy stuff this time.
Hello there! We have lots of high quality equipment for sale, all forged with the power of the smug. Take your pick!
Let's see. The armor for a start.
Buy bronze armor for 250G.
Yeah. There's more protection then. And some boots.
Buy smoke boots for 150G.
Yeah. And the bells.
Buy a smoke belt for 100G?
Yeah. That'll be it. For now, at least.
Thank you. Come back soon.
Partially blind and deaf. Looks like the guards are female. In this time period. Oh look, it's a mini Sakura. Character from the Street Fighter games. Well, some of them certainly.
When I was young, I often came and played in the streets of Genova. But after the great disaster, the city became a terrible place with the traders and the profits seizing power. Makes me cough, and many residents have fallen sick as well. Ever since, I've cut down trips to Genova as much as possible.
Don't blame you.
Gaze at this fountain, I think of the future. The prophet has revealed it to us. He alone holds the truth. Water will wash over the worlds and all will be flooded. Great destroyers are already at work, but the prophets will save us.
Yeah, let me know when that happens.
Sure, the great disaster flattened the whole power of the continent, but that's also where we get Smug from. As they say, all's well that ends well, right? Well, except for all the victims of the great disaster, of course. But then, apparently they didn't suffer at all. Boom! Gone in an instant! I mean, I don't know much about it, eh? I wasn't born yet.
Nor do I. Perhaps when I'm done exploring the city as it is now, I think a trip to the library might be in order. There are no sorcerers around there now. Huh? What? My legs stretched out underground. I can commune with that great destroyer. The great destroyer is omnipotent. He will destroy the world in order to rebuild it. Do you think you can hear me? I see there are some disciples that slack off. Oh no. Dolphins. Huh. It's gone strangely upmarket. There! It's your lucky day! You just won this gem of a home! Claiming it's so simple, Giles could do it! A child with 10,000 G, that is my modest purchase fee! So, what you say? Sorry, I don't have that much. Listen, I like the color you jib, so I'm gonna go out of my way to offer you a reduced price. $5,000 G is my final offer. So, what do you say? I don't even have that much. You drive a hard bargain, okay? 500 G in cash up front. You got a deal. Ah! Thank you! Thank you! Thank you! I'm most delighted to get real. I mean, to sell you this charming abode. Enjoy your new home. Obviously had some debts to pay. Would like to sleep? No. Not yet. What? Can I even smashed the pots in my own home. The store is closed, so I can't get in there. I can't get in here.
I can't seem to find my key to the library. I'm certain I left it here. I simply must find it to continue my study with the scientific explanation for the predominance of traitors in. An religious system within a post-disastrous society. And where has Mimi gone? Still hanging around with her friends, I suppose. Well, as long as she stays out of trouble and lets me work. Where is that blasted key?
That man's daughter and her friends would be a good lead to getting that key. If, of course, it were relevant. Right now, it isn't. Yeah, definitely more upmarket. I don't remember this floor.
Check everything first. Mimi, did you get the key? Yep, sucker! I got it! Brilliant! How about you, Ribbon? You have the map? Yeah, boss. I got the map. Awesome. I hereby declare Operation No Toys But Play Your Books has begun. Sako, I think we should come up with a better name for our operation. I think so too! Super Mimi!
Ugh, no! Mimi, it's not just your operation, it's all of ours! And so, might I suggest, Operation Sako and Her Friends.
No way! Why should there only be your name in our operation? Maybe it's because it was my idea in the first place? Well, I'm the one who stole my dad's key. Books are hidden in the library. Stop pouring around me, toys. So? So why not call out Operation Books for Ribbon?
Can you do? Will they get into the library? How will they get the key to get in? Find out next time on Evoland 2, a slight case of space-time continuum disorder.